Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Hope you all are doing extremely well. So today in this video we are going to solve a problem on Codeforces, that is closing the gap, right? So this was recently asked on Codeforces. The question was like a pretty easy one based on some observation. It's like we can say that it is a like math based problem. So let's understand the problem now, and like then we'll be coming to the coding part. So what the problem says is that there are n block towers in a row. They are where tower I has a height of ai. You are part of a building crew and you want to make the buildings look as nice as possible. In a single day you can perform the following operation: choose two indices I and j and move a block from tower I to tower j. This essentially decreases ai by 1 and increases aj by 1. So what you are doing is that you are choosing two indices, and if you are moving the block from tower I to tower j, so ai will be decreased by 1 and aj will be increased by 1. So what you have to do is you think the ugliness of the building is the highest, is the height difference between the tallest and the shortest building. It means maximum of the given array, let's say a, and the minimum of array. So the difference between these two is going to determine the ugliness of the buildings, right? So even they have mentioned the same, that formally the ugliness is defined as max a minus min a. So what's the minimum possible ugliness you can achieve after any number of days? So this is the input given to us. So there is no restriction. Agar aap ye wala operation kar rahe ho that they have mentioned, so iske regarding there is no restriction. The only thing they want to know is that the minimum possible ugliness that you can achieve. So they are interested in knowing the minimum possible ugliness. Input, you can see the first line contains one integer t, the number of test cases. The t cases follow. The first line of each test case contains one integer n, the number of buildings. And the second line contains n space separated integers a1, a2 up to an, the height of the building. So the output for each test case, output you have to give a single integer, which is basically determining the minimum possible ugliness of the building. So this is the input given to us. Right, so here you can see all the values are equal, right? All the values are equal, so that's why we are getting the minimum ugliness as 0. In this scenario, if you will see, in this scenario, see what you're doing is, in the second test case, you should do one operation with I equal to 1 and j equal to 3. This one, I equal to 1 and j equal to 3. Due to which, what will happen now? That iski height will increase by 1 and iski this will decrease by 1. So we'll be getting the equal error. You can see here. So that's why here the minimum ugliness that you are getting is 0. And in this scenario, if you will check, even they have explained the same, that is 1. So one thing to observe here, by the test case itself, you will be able to observe that ugliness can be less than equal to 1. So the value, the minimum ugliness that you can get is either it will be 0 or 1. So minimum value that you are going to get, that will be 0 or 1. So how we can check like whether it will be 0 or 1? So here if you will check that the sum of these elements in the array, for example in this one, 10 plus 10 plus 10, 30, 30 divided by 30 modulus by 3, 30 divided by 3, if you will check for the remainder, you are going to get 0. Here in this case, if you will check, so 3, 2 plus 5, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 1, 8, and divide, if you are going to divide it by 4, the remainder will be 0. In this scenario, if you're going to check, so 5 plus 1, 6 plus 3, 9 plus 2, 11 plus 1, 12. So in this case, what you're going to get is, this is not properly divisible, right? In this case, it is not properly divisible. So what we can derive from this particular case is that if the summation of the elements that you are having in your array, if the modulus of this summation by the value of n is equal to 0, it means the minimum ugliness that we can get is, that will be 0. Otherwise, it is going to be 1. So yeah, that's the solution that most of you must have come up with. So this was the solution for this particular problem. So now let's understand the code for the same. So here you can see we have just implemented the same thing. We have taken the test cases as input and the number of elements in array as input. Then we are just simply summing up the elements and we are just checking that if sum mod n is equal to 0, we have to simply print 0 and we have to just underline, otherwise we have to print 1. So yeah, this was the solution for this particular problem. We'll be discussing the next solution in next video. So make sure to subscribe our channel. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Keep learning, keep preparing. Bye bye.